Hello, I'm Paul Phear. This is my Mo.
That's very nice.
Thank you for not drawing too much attention to it. Actually, somebody said to me the other day, if I had a nose that big, I wouldn't draw a line on it.
But... Rude. You know, so many people have got moustaches that I just...
It's going. It's going very soon. So you're quite
good.
Lucky to
keep
see
it.
This. And this is Louise Dearman, who is a phenomenal singing talent. You are the only actress to have played both major roles in Wicked.
Yes.
Galinda.
Amazing.
Garlinda.
Garlinda.
And Elphaba.
Yeah.
And you've just finished a whole year as Elphaba.
Yes. Literally just Saturday the 16th of November I finished. So I'm in that kind of zone of, am I on holiday? Am I going back soon? Or is that it kind of place? But amazing, amazing experience. Like you said, I'm very, very lucky and grateful to have been able to play both roles. But it's been a wonderful, wonderful year.
Whose idea was it then? Because you were Galinda first.
Yes.
And then you had a little break. And then
10 months off. It was actually, I mean, I'm not going to lie. I would be playing Galinda and looking up at Rachel Tucker, who was playing Elphaba at the time, and think, I'd love to give that a go. But I don't think I would have ever put myself forward to do it. And I got a phone call actually during the audition stage from Petra, who's our associate director. And she just said, we sat there on the panel and we're just thinking, we can't find the person we want. And they just all said, why don't we get Lou in? And she called me and said, what do you think about coming in, you know, to sing for us? And I think my words were, can I sleep on it? Because I suddenly thought, my heart started racing. I was thinking, really? And then felt a bit terrified and then had that whole thing of, could I actually do it? But of course, once I woke up and thought, do you know what, how amazing would that be? And went for it. So it's their idea. It's all down to them.
So you must have been asked this many times. Which was your favourite?
That's really hard. I love comedy. So Galinda quenched that thirst for my love of comedy. And also she kind of challenged me to use my soprano voice. But, of course, it's amazing. The transformation into Elphaba, being greened up every night. I felt more comfortable in her shoes, in her boots, as it were. I kind of like that whole... slightly tomboyish.
There's quite a range, isn't there, with Elphaba? You start off with this kind of slightly naive schoolgirl.
Yeah, and hopeful then, young schoolgirl.
Yes, that's right, keen.
Yeah.
And then you become
You know, everyone is saying she's wicked and there's only so many times you can hear that before you say, do you know what, okay, that's it. If that's what you want me to be, that's what I'll be. But she was an amazing character to play. And like you said, hopeful, positive, passionate, stood up for what she believed in for other people. You know, I'd love to be more like her. Yeah. She's amazing to play. And, of course, those show-stopping numbers.
Yeah. And you get that big belt as well, don't you, at the end of Act One.
It's hardcore.
Yeah,
it's hardcore.
Absolutely. But you are a belter, aren't you? I mean, I've listened to your album and there's some tracks on there where you just let it ring
out. I love
out.
A good belt.
Yeah.
I love to
What is a belt for people
down.
Who don't know? What?
So a belt, if you listen to someone, if you think of the, you know, Shirley Bassey, Barbara Streisand, Celine Dion, those big voices, and they hit those, what we call the money notes, a big, loud note.
And
that's
long
a belt.
As well.
And
that's,
long,
that's,
yeah, usually.
That's the trick, isn't
really,
it?
Really milk it for all it's worth.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that was, Elphaba was definitely a challenge, but I love, like with on the album, there's lots of huge songs with big finishes, and that's what I love to do.
Don't we all?
Yeah. Give us a go.
Oh, my God.
Give us your belt.
You wouldn't want to hear that, really.
But not warmed up.
This is your third album.
Yes.
Which might be a surprise to some people.
Yeah. But... I mean, the first album, You and I did, years and years ago. I can't remember the year I did it now. And it was all just songs that I loved, you know, off the back of doing my first few jobs. I think it was straight after Jekyll and Hyde, actually. And just a collection of songs that I loved from musical theatre, some well-known, some not so well-known. And it was just with piano, very simple. My second album, Here Comes the Sun, was completely different. I was in a completely different place. And I kind of went back to what I love listening to, the artists I grew up listening to, you know, Annie Lennox, Alison Moyet, Skunk Anansie, Alanis Morissette, all those amazing artists, and took those contemporary songs and gave them a theatrical, dramatic feel so that it still sat with my style, if you like. Absolutely love that album. And this album, It's Time, has gone back to musical theatre and fully embraced the classics, those kind of songs actually that have never passed my lips. I Dreamed a Dream, What I Did for Love, Sending the Clowns, classic theatre songs that usually I'd be a bit scared of touching. but we absolutely went for it, fully embraced it. There's beautiful orchestrations. It's a big sound and they're big
songs. It's amazing. I mean, where was it recorded?
At Silver Screen Studios in Camden. And literally, I recorded it whilst playing Elphaba. And so it took a long time because there'd be, as you can probably imagine, singing Elphaba is very demanding. And there'd be often times that I'd, you know, pick up the phone in the morning and call my producer and say, it's not going to happen today. And just leave it and go back. But they were very patient and I wanted to take my time with this album and make sure I did justice to these big songs. But I'm thrilled with the outcome.
It sounds phenomenal. I mean, I've not listened to it, the whole thing, but you've got a sampler on your website.
Yes, little teaser.
It's fantastic. And the song on there called Home.
Yes.
Which I didn't know was from The Wiz.
The Wiz.
Which was the black version of The Wizard
of Oz.
Yeah, exactly. I remember seeing it at the time.
There's a nice link there. But it's a song that I was aware of years and years ago, and I actually sang it at my first ever cabaret, Madame Jojo's. In Soho.
Oh,
and
God, Madame Jojo's.
Yeah, Madame Jojo's. Love it there. I went back for more. I love it.
I left my dress there actually, last time.
Did you? I love it. But no, it was a great little venue, brilliant show. And that was my encore. And so I thought, you know what? I haven't sung that in a long time. Let's throw that in.
Yeah. You've got concerts coming up and
yes.
The Water Babies.
The Water Babies.
New musical.
Yes.
What's that?
The Water Babies is obviously, it's a brand new musical based on the children's book, The Water Babies, and the film, but isn't exactly based on that. It's a brand new production. They've taken, I don't know if you know the story, but a young boy called Tom, who is a chimney sweep's assistant, if you like. He gets accused of stealing. And Mrs. Do, as you would be done by, who I'm playing, sends him down into the water to the Water Babies. If you imagine something like Oliver and all the little boys in that, there's kind of this team of young people. But rather than it being a very young boy, it's a teenager in this production. And it's all brand new music. I've heard lots of it and it's fantastic. It's a brilliant mix of kind of contemporary pop / theatre music. I get some cracking numbers. And apparently there's lots of special effects I'm looking forward to seeing. It's hard to imagine how it's going to be.
It's going to be underwater.
It's not going to be underwater. I got a little bit shifty about the thought of me having to, you know, dive into some tank on stage in my bikini every night. That's no good for anyone. No one's going to pay to see that. But no, apparently special effects will be quite something. So I'm looking forward to seeing it.
And some concerts coming up at the St James Theatre.
Yes.
Which I've not been yet. It's
London's, brilliant
London's
venue.
Newest venue,
yes.
Isn't it?
And there's two venues in there. I'm playing the studio on the 16th and 17th of December. Tickets are actually almost all gone now, which is brilliant. Just a few left. And it's going to be a lovely mix of my theatrical past, some little teasers of what's to come, and loads of Christmas songs. So I literally decided on my set list yesterday and my guests. But there's also too much in there, so I need to go through and like sift through it. But very exciting. I want it to be, you know, a really fun show. An intimate evening with Dearman.
Ooh. Which I think we're having right now. A little intimate moment there. And a tour next year as well.
Yeah, my first ever UK tour off the back of the album. It kicks off in Somerset in February and goes through to April. Very, very excited about that.